Studio 10 and just a couple more sleeps till Christmas with all that beautiful food. But the feast on offer raises a question, what do you do with the leftovers? Let's welcome chef and author Vali Little.
So lovely to see you again.
Good to be here.
What can we do? Because you have so much leftover food in the fridge.
Absolutely. Look, we all over cater at Christmas time, I think. But for me, the leftovers often taste better than the big meal itself because there's so much anticipation for that and, you know, getting the turkey in the oven. Mm. So I rather like sort of what you can do with the bits left over.
Something that better than the old so bubble and squeak.
Well, exactly. So what I've done here is just using store-bought puff pastry, a turkey, ham and mushroom pie. And just really easy. It's just sort of a white sauce that you mix, you know, with the leftover ingredients.
And can I cut into it?
Literally, yes, like there's a knife there.
What's that thing?
Look, I bought that because I thought you'd ask me how I get the top like that.
So basically, there was some weird cutting technique you meant to do.
So basically, I've just put one sheet of plain puff on the top with the filling and then rolled over the second sheet of pastry with this little gadget that you get at kitchenware shops.
And yum.
Yeah,
look at that.
Just makes it look rather pretty.
What a fabulous idea.
And that's a great thing to take on picnics. Mm. It's good hot or cold. Mm. These are little ham and potato croquettes. So mashed potato, chopped ham, there's some peas, a few frozen peas in there, some mint, and you just make them into little croquettes, cover them in breadcrumbs and fry them.
Yum!
I've just served those with a little store-bought aioli because I think Christmas is all about doing some things yourself you know, buying a few little bits and pieces.
Delicious. And now you've got a turkey salad.
Turkey salad.
Oh, so I don't like turkey, I've got to say.
Oh, really?
So, but this
looks like
lovely.
Chicken?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, well, look, you can make it with barbecue chicken.
Yes.
You can put ham in there, you can do anything you want, but the basic is just, you know, some nice fresh Asian ingredients that go in there.
So you got mint,
Thai basil, some carrots, some chili, some cherry tomatoes, and just a dressing with fish sauce and lime juice and a little bit of sugar.
Sorry, I'm a bit full in the tummy already, so I've just tucked my topping.
Now, I'm going to get you guys to help me because we're going to cook today some little fruit mince pancakes. And often, you know, you make your mince pies and you end up with jars of fruit mince left over.
I love mince pies.
Yeah, me too. Oh. Me too. So,
so
I'll just
do?
Get you. So mix all this in together. We need to break an egg.
Someone can drop an egg in there. Now I've been talking about how bad I am at cooking.
You crack the egg.
Two cups of flour and
just normal flour.
Baking powder. Self-raising flour.
Okay, self-raising flour.
That goes in. That's a mixture of buttermilk and milk. So that can go
yummy.
In. And then, Jess, you want to just literally throw in
all
that.
Of it.
That's six tablespoons of fruit mince.
And I'll this fruit mince, though, you can just buy it in a jar,
you
can't
you? You just buy it in the supermarket, and it's just lovely. It's got all those lovely festive flavours of cinnamon and...
It smells Christmassy,
know,
doesn't it, fruit
I know,
mince?
And I think
you can't have it at any other time of the year. It won't
exactly.
Taste right.
And then we'll just give this a little whisk together. Did we put the sugar in?
No. Oh, was that the sugar? And then do we put this in?
Yeah, a little bit of vanilla bean paste. So,
I love this.
That's
have a
good
smell.
Stuff.
Yummy.
Yum.
Oh, I love the smell of vanilla.
So just sort of like a teaspoon of that.
So
in
just
there.
A splash?
Yeah, a splash of it in there. Lovely. Oh, look, it's Christmas. That's fine.
You did say you love vanilla. God, you enjoy these very much.
And these are a great thing to do, sort of, you know.
And that's mixed enough?
In the morning, that's mixed enough.
And then do we blob it in?
Blob it in. So I'm just cooking it in coconut oil because I love cooking with coconut oil.
It's much healthier. And I love when I cook my veggies in coconut oil and you get that little bit of a coconut flavour
hint. Just a little, not too much. But it's really easy to regulate the temperature too, whereas if you cook with, you know, olive oil or peanut oil, it's not so easy. So
could you use normal oil or that spray? I quite like that spray.
The spray is good.
Yeah.
Now,
so you're doing little
I'm doing little ones.
Pancakes.
So these you'd serve up for breakfast or for afternoon tea at Christmas. And they're like a little pikelet, a sweet pikelet. And we're just going to pile them up on a plate and put some caramel sauce and some cream with them.
So everything you say about it sounds better.
Okay. The secret is when little bubbles appear on the surface, then you know it's time to sort of flip them over. But you want to make sure that they're cooked all the way through.
And do you need the bubbles all the way in the middle?
No, just a few bubbles appear on the surface. Mm-hmm. And that, you see, we're just starting here with this one. So
Valley, would you do it as a big pancake or are they better as
little
clusters?
You could do a big one if you wanted to, yeah. But I rather like stacking pancakes.
Yeah, they look more impressive.
Yeah, they do.
That'd be nice, wouldn't it?
Don't take the pan off.
Denise, this is the induction. The induction.
Right. And Denise, we love induction.
Yeah, and she is our expert induction cooker. Oh. And she actually does the class. She,
oh, really?
Yes.
Do not.
And teaches everyone.
Don't go away. We might need you.
From the sidelines.
The best way to cook on these hot tops. Is it a hot top? What do you call it? A hot plate thing.
A hot plate.
I have exciting news for us.
What?
We are, Denise... Be calm. We're actually getting a new cooktop on set.
Yay! Yay! It's Christmas!
It's not induction.
Oh.
Good.
Oh.
Yay.
How much better
is
that?
Extreme high to a low.
Really?
Oh, it is, because this thing never works. But Valerie, you've got it working beautifully.
I mean, I'm nervous about it. My trouble is I'm a little heavy-handed and you need to be light-handed with induction.
Yeah.
And if you keep pressing and sort of
getting
asking... Because all of a sudden it heats up and you...
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. So we're just going to flip this
smell
last little one over.
Don't they?
And then...
I think you're very neat with your pancakes.
Oh, do you?
Yes, I do.
So Just make sure they cook through. Mm-hmm. Now, what I've got here is just some store-bought caramel sauce, just to gild the lily.
Caramel.
Let's stack them up.
And can I get you to pass me the icing sugar? Because we need to make sure they look beautiful too.
My mouth is watering.
Look, they're right, just fun, go. I think, and you know.
And they smell delicious,
yeah.
Don't they?
So good.
Yum. All right, let's stack them up and pour some sugar on me.
That's one.
Oh, look, it looks pretty already. It's a stack.
It's a stack. The stack is back.
And then do we put
non-creative.
This on?
Yeah. I'm going to put that in your hand.
And then do we do this?
Let's do a little bit of icing sugar first.
Oh, doesn't that look pretty?
And then, yeah, pour.
And then pour that over the top.
Over the top. Oh. And then we'll just... Beautiful.
That's the drizzle. You know how you in the restaurant you get the drizzle?
And then we'll
this is called
a little
plating
bit of whipped cream.
Oh, so, look at that.
That's a little more caramel sauce than we need.
We've got to try some.
Well, we'll put all these recipes up on Studio 10's Facebook page and look for Valley's new book, My Kind of Food. It's published early in the new year. Thank you so much, Valley.